All right, in we go. There's the exit. But how are we supposed to get up there? It's way too high. Let's keep going. Maybe there's something in this facility that will help. Take it out. Better be good. Thank you. That's a step in the right direction. Let's find some more cell bots. Unrefined E-turner looks toxic. I hope none of the core bots have been using it. Workbench. That might come in handy.
Like I said, you can't have a CoreBot without a frame. And the scientist who invented the frame is, of course, your mission leader and chief scientist, Dr. Julius Roldan. Did I ever tell you how he and I met? It was the first mandate conference for all the research groups around the world working on the Dust Devil crisis. There were hundreds of people there, and Julius just happened to sit next to me. He told me he liked my Robbie the Robot t-shirt. And then he cracked a crazy joke about robotics researchers and their armies of killer robots. He was outspoken, ambitious, the exact opposite of me. I felt like a geek hanging out with a rock star. But ever since that day, Julius was more than my colleague. He was my friend.
What we got. Hey, this is a part to a flyer core bot. If we can build the whole frame, it'll carry us up to the exit. Come on, let's find the rest of the flyer parts. Thank you. Another part.
Refining E-Turner isn't easy. There would never be enough of it to fuel all the CoreBots we wanted. Shortages were inevitable if we weren't careful.
just... another flyer part. Like another cell bot got scared out of its socket. What we got. Yes! We've got everything we need to make a flyer. There was a workbench back where we found the first part. Let's go, guys. This ought to be good. Looking good, Seth. Now we can fly up to the exit door. That's a big gap, but we should be able to glide across. I got a bad feeling about this. You can try and stop us, but it's not gonna work.
Thank you.
dust devil. When your mom got infected, she wasn't afraid of dying. She was only afraid of leaving you. Now, I told her not to worry, that even if something happened to me, I'd make sure you had someone to look after. And that someone was Mag, the dog you always wanted. Just without any fur to trigger my allergies. Your mom. Her concern was the catalyst for my core research. Sometimes your own desire to do something isn't enough. You need something to push you. And now there's another push coming. News broke today of a dust devil outbreak. The first one in over a decade. I might have to take a break from these messages for a while, Joule. Things are gonna be busy. Give Mac a hug for me.
I'm here to reactivate this tower and turn Far Eden into the home that was promised to all of us. Look! Victor has misled you! When the other ships land, he will be punished!
There are no ships.
That's a lie. There are dozens of ships in orbit. My father told—
There are no ships. I destroyed them long ago. There are no more humans. You are the last.
No. That's not true. There is another and we... Kai.
Your friend is dead. You are alone, and Far Eden belongs to me. Give me the Prismatic Cores.
Joule, if anyone could set things right, I knew it would be you.
I'm not alone. And we're taking Far Eden back!
Thank you.
Prismatic Cores!
Victor, what has he done to the E-Tower? This can't be its original design. Up we go.
2240. I don't know when my tube began to fail. It must have been years ago. My mind remained in stasis, but my body... When the failsafes finally woke me up, my first thought was to call for Victor. It didn't take long for him to track my emergency beacon. When I saw him, I knew something even more horrible had happened. Victor's core... It has turned black. I've never seen anything like it. And his voice... He asked me, did I still believe in Far Eden? Did I think that humans and CoreBots could build a world together? Before I could even answer, he told me, there can be no Far Eden without trust. And he cannot trust any human. Not even me. I asked him, what about the mandate ships? The other crew still sleeping in their crawlers. Victor looked at me with his cold, black eyes and said, I will do whatever is necessary to protect Far Eden. My God. What have I done?
Dang it! We don't have enough prismatic cores. We should look for new places to explore, and go back to places we've already been, to make sure we didn't miss any prismatic cores.